Antarctica, a place of extremes, extreme weather matched by its extreme beauty. Many view it as a barren and lifeless land, except for the occasional penguin. I recently led an expedition to Antarctica in pursuit of dispelling this common misperception by searching for and filming extremophiles, tiny microbes living beneath the ice. With approximately 185 pounds of gear, I set out on a journey to the ends of the Earth, first flying 15 hours to Christchurch, New Zealand, to be issued my extreme cold weather clothing from the quartermaster. Then next boarding a C-17 military transport aircraft for the five-hour flight to Antarctica, eventually landing on a runway made of compacted snow. Along the way, in that military aircraft, I was able to peer through a very tiny window and get my very first sight of Antarctica. It was breathtaking, to say the least. After 5 years of effort, I have actually landed in Antarctica. I am exhausted, as you can probably tell from my voice and what I look like, but oh my God, it's just overwhelming to finally be here. It's like landing on the moon. It's surreal and difficult to take in. So now I'm actually in my dorm room in McMurdo. I have just gotten a whirlwind tour of everything today as my first day. There's a lot to go through, but I'm really excited because I have an office and a lab and I've got a dorm room. And so this is going to be my home for the next month, and it already feels pretty home-like. It's really great here and it's just amazing to see so much. Today is my second day in Antarctica. I am still incredibly, incredibly excited to be here, although I am definitely now feeling tired. I think most of the adrenaline that I had yesterday has drained from me, and so I am a bit struggling to get through stuff tonight. I had a really fun training, an informal training that was called Lady Business in the Field, and that all consisted of a group of women getting together and sharing tips and tricks about how to go into the field as a lady. That consisted mostly of how to pee, how to poop, and how to menstruate in field camps and these sites that were developed usually with only men in mind, or with clothing that only had men in mind, or in scenarios where there are only men around and we have to squat and do things in a different way than everyone else, which makes it a bit awkward. It was definitely a very helpful and very funny workshop to sort of be a part of. And definitely fun to hear a lot of the horror stories that other women had to go through. So now I am a lot smarter and hopefully will have less awkward moments whenever I go into the field. So many other things to tell you about, but I'll leave it at that for now because I'm so tired, and hopefully I'll just catch up on more stuff in the coming days. Nervous for tomorrow. Tomorrow is sea ice training. They're going to take us out on the sea ice and teach us how to drill holes and check for cracks and other things of that nature. Definitely very useful information that I'm going to have, but I'm a little bit nervous being outside for so long because I've only been outside for 5 to 15 minutes at a time usually, and tomorrow I'm going to be outdoors for hours. And so it's going to probably be a bit intense. I'm probably going to be very tired, but it's also exciting. You know, I'm a little scared, but excited too. It's my fourth day here in Antarctica. I've been spending all of my days in trainings. You spend the first full week here doing endless trainings. Today, I trained on how to use a GPS, much like the 90s, doing geocaching and things of that nature. And I also got my pager. Going back here to Antarctica is like going back to the 1990s. People have pagers, they have landlines, they write down their calendars in notebooks with pencil. It's a bit intense. Anyway, tonight is the Halloween party, so I'm about to go check that out. So let's go check it out. Day 5 of my time in Antarctica. This morning was quite good. So there is a big Sunday brunch that they do every Sunday. And it was quite welcome after dancing a ton last night at the Halloween party, which is definitely a memory that I'm going to have forever.
On the next episode, I go under the sea ice with Antarctic divers in search of microbes living within the seafloor. To catch all the episodes of my Antarctic expedition, be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel. My Antarctic work is ongoing, and you can support it and get fun perks and gifts by joining my Patreon crew. Thanks to all my current patrons, and a special shout out to the patrons listed in the YouTube description below. You all rock. Also, thank you to the National Science Foundation Antarctic Artists and Writers Program, the San Francisco Microscopical Society, National Geographic, and the many Antarctic researchers, colleagues, and friends for supporting this project.